Okay, so in this short video, we're going to be looking at the phase and lever rules. The phase rule is really important because it defines the conditions of equilibrium. It's one of those rules that when I first saw it, I thought people were just making up. But actually, these equations are derived directly from the Gibbs rules of thermodynamics. So the phase rule can be written P plus F equals C plus 2. So P is the number of phases, F is the number of degrees of freedom, and C is the number of components. Now, for solid state systems, we can generally ignore any significant vapor phase. So we can simplify this down so that P plus F equals C plus 1. This is what we call the condensed phase rule. But this simplifies further for us because in our systems, we're only looking at binary systems. And so C is always going to be 2 because we've got two components. So therefore, this simplifies even further for us. P plus F equals 3. So the idea of this is that we can look at any point on our phase diagram and determine whether it makes sense because we can know what the conditions of equilibrium should be at every point. So for example, if we have the liquid phase up here, at all points in this phase field, we just have a single phase, liquid. So P equals 1. That means P plus F equals 3. That means that the number of degrees of freedom must be 2 in the liquid field. Okay, and that means that for every temperature and composition, we have a different state for the liquid. Also, in these two fields, we know we have two phases. These are the primary phase fields of A and the primary phase field of B. So if I label this up here, we know we've got A plus liquid in here and B plus liquid in here. So P equals 2 and F equals 1. So we need 1 degree of freedom. Down here, we have two phases again. So P equals 2, F equals 1. Anywhere along the eutectic line, we have three phases. So P equals 3, which means we have no degrees of freedom. So that means we have to fix all of the variables to define the system at any given point. Okay, so let's move on. Let's imagine that we've got a point somewhere in the primary phase field of A. So we'll draw this on here in green. So this point, we'll say, is roughly composition 10B90A. Okay. So we're in the primary phase field. So at this point, at this temperature, we have a mixture of A plus liquid. But how much of each do we have? And what is the composition of the liquid? Well, we can find that out quite easily. First of all, we draw on an isotherm, a line of constant temperature, and then find where it intersects with the phase boundaries. So we hit one phase boundary here and the other one here. If we then simply draw on two isoplaths, that's lines of constant composition, down onto the composition axis, well, we can see, yep, no surprises, we've hit A. So in this region, we have A, plus we've hit liquid here, so we have liquid. And if we draw on our isopleth here, we can see that the liquid composition is about 50B. Okay, so A plus liquid in there with the liquid composition 50B, but the overall composition for the system is 10B. Okay, now the lever rule comes into its own here because that will tell us the relative concentrations of both of those phases. So if we label these up X, Y, and Z here, the fraction of liquid in this system at this point here is given by the distance x, y over x, z. So if I write this up to the left here, so the fraction of liquid is x, y over x, z. I always find this a bit counterintuitive when I first learned this, because you kind of imagine, you want to know about the liquid, you're gonna go towards the liquid. But actually it's the other way around. So if you want to know how much liquid you've got, you measure this distance over the whole distance. So you take the ratio xy to xz, and that gives you the fraction of liquid. If we want to know how much A we have, we do the opposite. So it's yz over xz, and that gives us the relative proportions of the liquid and the crystalline phase A in our system at this data point. You can just measure these off using rulers and you'll get a relatively accurate value.